My name is Eric Milo. I go to Florida State University and I'm majoring in mechanical engineering. My project was to come up with a computer model that can run a simulation to see the response of an impact to the human chest. The way the thorax was modeled was with a mass spring damper system. It consisted of three masses, the sternal and spinal mass, and the impactor mass. And in between the three masses, there was a few springs and dampers that were put there to represent the response of all the internal organs and the skeletal structure as a result of the impact. The mass spring damper model that we're using in this project was originally developed for testing car crash dummies to see if they properly represented the human body. So we took that model and kind of altered it and changed it in the way that it applied to our specific scenario, meaning on the International Space Station. You have an average car crash happening anywhere between 20 to 40 miles per hour, and your impacts occurring on the space station from normal translation are just anywhere between 1 to 4 or 5 miles per hour. So a very big difference. However, the biggest difference and the reason why it's still a concern is something that a lot of people don't realize is that in space, because of the microgravity, there really is no theoretical limit to the size of an object that you can move. Yes, you have to overcome the inertial properties of actually getting it in motion, but you can take something that is 100 kilograms or 1,000 kilograms and you can move it pretty much just the same.
Eric did an extremely nice job for us. He was very hardworking, just kept driving towards the answer. And the amount of work he did was terrific, much more than expected. And the work that he produced will definitely be incorporated into the final product that we deliver to NASA Johnson.
I was able to apply what I learned in school to what my task was here. I had just taken a dynamic systems class and was able to apply it to another field. Since I got here, I mean, every day has kind of been a learning experience. You know, you come to work and you get new challenges and you run into more problems. You're constantly working to try to solve them and you're constantly growing. Coming to NASA and getting to work with some of the nation's most intelligent minds was an awesome experience. I was able to work shoulder to shoulder with a lot of them. I felt like I was brought into the team, and it really was a very good experience, a very good learning experience, being able to work alongside of such experts at what they do. Comparing this to a school or taking a course at school, the experience here is great. You get a lot of learning. If I had to associate like a credit number with this, I would say huge. You use everything that you've learned at school. I mean, pretty much everything I've learned mathematically and a lot of the just engineering way of thinking that I've learned, I utilized while I was here, so it's not like this could take the place of school, but it definitely kind of just took everything I've learned and put it all in one spot. The undergraduate student research program has given me so much. I mean, it is just a great experience. Definitely has changed my life. I'm going to be able to take these experiences and now this knowledge with me for the rest of my life and be able to apply it anywhere I go from here.